Going from Final Cut Pro to DVD Studio Pro using Compressor is the workflow that gets the best results with Final Cut Studio. Once your project is complete in Final Cut Pro, export a QuickTime reference movie. By reference, I refer to unchecking the Make Movie Self-Contained box and exporting the movie. I like creating a reference movie anyway because it gives me a copy of my project that is easy to access but doesn't take up much space on my hard drive. After creating the QuickTime, open it with Compressor and choose an appropriate MPEG-2 and AC3 preset, or create your own. A safe bet is to use the DVD Best Quality 90-minute preset. You can use a higher encode bitrate, but the chance of playback issues on lesser machines also increases. The next step is to choose where Compressor will put the new files. If you leave the destination as source, Compressor will place the file in the same location the QuickTime movie came from. Or if you go into Destinations, you can choose a different destination. To wrap up in Compressor, select Submit, and then Submit again, and wait for the file to process. Once Compressor has finished, collect all the audio and video files, and simply bring them right into a track in DVD Studio Pro. Then delete the menu, and set the track as the first play. The only step left is to output. Choose Build Format, and you will be able to name your disk before selecting Build Burn to actually start the output. That's it! Simple, right? Final Cut Pro, DVD Studio Pro, and Compressor are just three of the five applications we teach in our 5-day Final Cut Studio class at Genius DV. Sign up today to learn a contemporary Final Cut Studio workflow.